Greetings to you, beloved. Welcome back. I'm Chelsea Barrett, and freedom is calling you now. The word of God to you this week is bring back the blood. Bring back the blood. And even right now, as I'm sitting here, I hear the Father saying, bring back the blood. Bring back the blood. In this season, I've called many of you to new places. I've called many of you to occupy new territory. I've called many of you into a new door. You have been in transition, but now I place a door before you, and you will need the blood. You will need the blood of Jesus to go through that door. You will need the blood of Jesus to sustain that door. You will need the blood of Jesus to open that door. So bring back the blood. I say to you, bring back the blood of my son. Bring back the blood. Oh, Jesus. We thank you for that, Lord Jesus. We worship you. We worship you and we thank you for the blood. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ah, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. You are always faithful. When God first gave me this word, he just said one sentence to me, bring back the blood. And I thought to myself, God, I know what that means. I know how to apply the blood, but are you going to give me some more? Like, what else are you saying? So thank you, God, for being faithful. You're always faithful. You say, open my mouth wide and you will fill it. So glory to you for that today, Father God. So let's go ahead and unpack that. The scripture that the Lord gave me for this week is Isaiah 53. We're going to read through that and then start applying some things. You know, knowledge without application is really not power. People say knowledge is power, but if you don't apply that knowledge, it's not power. So when God gives you something, you have to know how to apply it. We need to know how to appropriate it. Everything in the Word of God is for us. Every word, every rhema word that God gives us is for us, but we play a role. We have to be able to appropriate it. So we're going to do some of those things during the activation today, as well as we're going to receive Holy Communion today during the activation. So if you'd like to put me on pause right now to go and receive, get your supplements for the communion, you can do so. Or if you don't have any, just go ahead and take it with us by faith when we come to that segment, okay? Glory to God. So today, the scriptures that the Lord gave me for this program is from Isaiah 53, and we're going to read through the whole thing. I really want us to hear what God is saying through the scripture as well, and let's just chew on this. Let's have it just go through every fiber of our being. Hear the word today with your ears, but process it through your hearts. Amen? Let's have a look right now. This is Isaiah 53, and we're going to start at verse 1, which says, He who has believed our message and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed. He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain, like one from whom people hide their faces. He was despised and we held him in low esteem. Surely he took up our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. I want to go back and just reread that portion again in Isaiah 53:4. I'm going to place a graphic on the screen right now, and it's going to be graphic. The graphic is going to be graphic, but I really want you to get a visual of this scripture. I really want you to get it down in your heart. This is not just words. It's so much more than that. This is Jesus. This is Jesus. So I'm going to place a graphic on the screen right now, and I'm going to reread this. Isaiah 53:4. Surely he took upon our pain and bore our suffering. He took upon our pain and bore our suffering. Yet we considered him punished by God, stricken by him and afflicted. But here we go. Isaiah 53:5. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. I like the King James version of this, by his stripes. 39 stripes he took at that time for us. By his stripes, by his wounds, we are healed. These aren't just words. These are the blood of Jesus. This is the flesh of Jesus. So let's go on. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before the shearer is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By oppression and judgment he was taken away, yet who of his generation protested? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgression of my people he was punished. He was assigned a grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, though he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life an offering for sin, he will see his offspring and prolong his days. And the will of the Lord will prosper in his hand. After he has suffered, he will see the light of life and be satisfied. By his knowledge, my righteous servant will justify many, and he will bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will give him a portion among the great, and he will divide the spoils with the strong, because he poured out his life unto death and was numbered with the transgressors. For he bore the sin of many and made intercession for our transgressions. Glory to God. The presence of the Lord is so strong in this place right now. And I pray that you are feeling the presence of Jesus that has descended right now in this place. I pray that you heard the words. I pray that you heard the words and that you saw the body, that you saw the blood, that you saw the flesh of Jesus Christ, that you saw what he did for you on the cross. These aren't just words. This is the flesh, the body, the purpose of Jesus Christ in your life. It's not just an Easter message. It's not just a nice, oh, that's nice. No, this is the body of Jesus Christ. Would you give your life for me? Would you give your life for humanity? I don't think so. But Jesus gave his life for you, and he's saying to us today to bring back the blood. He didn't die for nothing. He didn't die just for one generation. He didn't die just for one season. He says, bring back the blood. Revelations 12:11 says, they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. There's so much power in the blood. The blood is for fighting, yes. The blood is for restoration, yes. But the blood is for communing with the Lord so that we can be one with him. Everything we need is in the blood of Jesus. And God is saying to you today, bring back the blood. It's not old school. It's the blood of Jesus. It's the word of God. Bring back the blood today. That's what you need in your life. That's what you're going to need in this new season. I've entered a new season myself. Even at the beginning of this year, actually it started about fall of last year for me. I began to enter into a new season, and my spiritual father laid hands on me and professed that over me, that you've entered into a new season. And he prophesied so many wonderful things for me in this coming season. But that wasn't the end of it. When you enter a new season, as the word of God says, there's going to be enemies standing there at the door trying to oppose you. They don't want you to get into this door. They don't want you to get into this new season. They don't want you to have this revelation that God has for you. But it's going to require the blood. If God said it, he'll do it, but you play a role in it. You play a part. You have to bring back the blood. Bring back the blood. This year, as I was entering that new season, I was at the door. As they would say, all hell broke loose. I came up against some warfare that was serious, what they would call guerrilla warfare. It was serious. I had to bring back the blood and even bring back the blood to a new level. I had to appropriate that blood to get through that door. I had to use the blood to reach the revelation and the spiritual places and the natural places which God had for me. It's the same for you in this season, beloved. God wants you to bring back the blood. I'm going to put another graphic on the screen right now. One of the things that happened to me this year as I was entering this new season is the enemy began to come at me with all kinds of attacks. Attacks from people just saying whatever, and attacks on my car. Attacks just in every area you can imagine. But one of the things was an attack on my car. I had something happen to my car and then it just wouldn't stop. It was just one incident after the next, after the next, after the next. But when it first happened, I had to call a tow truck to come and tow my car to the dealership. And when the tow truck came, I heard the voice of God say, take a picture of your car. So I took a picture of the car as it was being loaded onto the tow truck and like hoisted up on the flatbed. I'll show that graphic now. I didn't think anything of it. But when my car was brought to the shop and some things started happening in the shop, there was just a lot of delay that was going on with it. And then finally I got the car back, and then right after I got it back, something else happened to it. And the Lord reminded me of that photograph that I took of the car. And on the photograph was the blood of Jesus. I hope you can see it, but the blood of Jesus was there on the photograph. I didn't see it when I took it. It wasn't actually like physically there, but somehow God had applied the blood of Jesus to it spiritually, and it came out there on the photograph to let me know that I had to use the blood. I had to use the blood of Jesus Christ. It may sound weird to you, it may sound spooky, but I don't care. It's what happened. It's what God told me and what He's telling me to share with you today. I had to really press in and apply the blood at a higher level to get things just eradicated out of my life, things that were trying to stop me from going through the new door that God had for me. I pray that you have ears to hear today. I pray that you have ears to know that God is saying to us to bring back the blood. And it's not just for warfare. It's not just for one season in particular of your life. God is saying bring back the blood, period. Yes, to go through the door, but the blood needs to be an everyday part of your life. So today we're going to get activated, and once we're activated, I'm going to demonstrate for you how I apply the blood every day in my life. The presence of God is just so heavy in this place today. I just thank you for your presence, Lord God. I thank you for your presence. We're going to first pray. You know, we always do this. We're going to pray to get you born again, get you into the family of Christ, or refreshed if you were already born again. And then we're going to activate this thing. Amen. So go ahead and close your eyes with me right now and let's pray. Remember, you need to pray this from your heart and really mean it in order for it to mean anything or do anything in your life. Close your eyes with me right now and just go ahead and repeat after me. Father God in heaven, I know that you are the one true God. Lord, I am a sinner. Father, please forgive me today of my sins. Lord, I believe that Jesus Christ is your Son. I believe that Jesus died on the cross for me and was risen again on the third day. Jesus, come into my heart right now. Be my Lord and Savior. Wash me with your blood. I submit to you right now, and I will live for you. Amen. Amen. I pray that you said that prayer from your heart and that you really meant it from your heart. It doesn't stop there. You're going to need to appropriate that blood every day. You're going to need to fellowship with God. Just start talking to Him, having conversations with Him. If you're not in a Spirit-filled local church, get one. Pray about finding the right one for you. That's going to nurture you and disciple you in the things of God and bring you to a point of maturity where you're standing in the fullness, the full blessing, the full knowledge, the full revelation, and the full relationship of who God and who Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit are in your life. Amen. So now I'm going to pray, and then we're going to receive Holy Communion, and then afterwards we'll see if the Lord has anything additional for us. As always, He never disappoints. Father, I thank you today for your people watching. I thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ. Lord, I release the blood of Jesus Christ over every person right now under the sound of my voice. Lord, I pray that you would prepare us right now, Father. Prepare us to receive the Holy Communion, the blood and the body of Jesus Christ today. Make us, Lord, make us ready. Make us acceptable today, Father, to receive your Holy Communion in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have your communion elements with you, we're going to receive the Holy Communion right now. If you don't receive it by faith, there are times in my life when I know that I need to receive communion, but I may be traveling or somewhere where I don't have communion, the elements, and I need to receive it by faith. I've even taken communion before with water and a biscuit. It's about really applying your faith. That's what it's about. So right now, I'm going to take the sacraments and I'm going to bless them. Father, I thank you for this communion elements today, Father. I pray your blessings over them, Father. I pray, Lord God, that as I receive these communion elements today, as the audience receives the communion elements today, Father, that their life will be changed forever in Jesus' name. Oh, Jesus, I thank you for your blood. I thank you for your body. I thank you for what you did on the cross for me. Jesus, I receive this bread right now as your body. I remember your body that was broken for me, Jesus. As you hold your bread right now in your hand, see the body of Jesus Christ on the cross. See his body that was broken for you. See the stripes of Jesus. Oh, Jesus, we break bread right now. We say, thank you, Jesus. We remember your body that was broken for us. We receive your body right now. That's such a strong presence of the Lord. Now for the blood. Jesus, we thank you for your blood today. We remember your blood that was shed for us, Jesus. We remember your blood that was shed in so many places on the cross, at circumcision, and even in other places that we're not even aware of. We remember your blood. We receive your blood today, Lord Jesus. We receive the cup of your new covenant. We become one with you today as we partake of your blood. We are one with you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. There is such a strong presence of the Lord here today. Wow. There's such a strong presence of the Lord here today. I'm just going to pray, hear what the Lord has to say, and then we're going to wrap. Father, I thank you for this precious time today. Jesus, I thank you for your presence in this place today. I thank you for your son and your daughter watching. I cover them with the blood of Jesus Christ right now, from the top of their head to the soles of their feet and all the way around their middle. And I demonstrate right now, Lord Jesus, how I appropriate the blood on a daily basis. I apply the blood of Jesus Christ to you right now. I draw the bloodline of Jesus Christ around you right now. And I decree and declare over you that no weapon formed formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rises in judgment against you is condemned in the name of Jesus Christ. I apply the blood of Jesus Christ to your body, to your mind, to your soul, to your will, to your finances, to your family, to your destiny, to your future, to your purpose, to everything concerning you. I apply the blood of Jesus Christ to your purpose that God is wanting to birth through you right now. I apply the blood of Jesus Christ to the door that God is calling you to walk through and hold open right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I cover you, I saturate you, I fumigate you right now in the blood of Jesus Christ. And I give you glory, I give you glory, I give you glory, I give you glory and honor for it, Father. I hear the Father saying right now, the blood of Jesus Christ is washing so many of you. The blood of Jesus Christ is washing so many of you, for there are those of you out there that are actually clothed and covered in the darkness of the enemy. I see so many of you right now, you have this thing over you. It's like a blackness. It's like a, almost like a molasses that the enemy has over you. It's very dark in color. It's thick, and there's so many of you that have been trying to penetrate through that. You've been trying to wash yourself. You've been saying certain prayers. You've been doing certain things. You've been watching certain people on TV, like trying to even catch a manifestation of something. But what God is saying to you today is it's the blood of Jesus Christ that's coming over you right now that's going to wash away that blackness. It's the blood of Jesus Christ that's going to set you free from those things in your life that's trying to entangle you, that's trying to snare you. I even see the door that's standing before many of you right now. I see the door in the spirit realm, but I see this black thing, this black trap thing that the enemy has dropped in front of your door, and it's trying to stop you. It's like you're trying to move through to the door, but there's this black thing. It's like a net. Thank you, Lord. That's the word. It's a net of the enemy. It's black that's trying to stop you from getting through that door. And even some of you, you've walked through the door, but the net is still covering you, so you're not able to be free. You're not able to be loose into the things that God has for you. But I see the blood of Jesus Christ coming down right now and breaking that net. I see the curtain being torn with the blood of Jesus Christ right now. So even in this program, as Jesus is pushing you through that door, it's going to be up to you to continue to appropriate the blood of Jesus Christ, to use it in your daily life, to make sure that you walk fully through that door and that you walk all the way up to the level that God is calling you to. Use the blood of Jesus as you walk through that door. Apply the blood of Jesus Christ daily into every circumstance, every situation, every prayer. Everything that you do, apply the blood of Jesus as a part of your daily life. Amen. Father, we thank you for that today. We thank you. As we're wrapping, I would like to recommend a marvelous book to you to just, excuse me, refresh your mind and even educate you on the blood of Jesus Christ. It's a book that I love. It's The Blood and the Glory by Billy Brim. Many of you may be familiar with it out there. If you're not familiar with it, get a copy of this book. It can really help you with some teaching and application on the blood of Jesus Christ. It's available at her website as well as on Amazon. Again, the book is The Blood and the Glory by Billy Brim. Amen. I pray this has been a blessing to you today. I will see you again next Sunday, same time, same place. Listen, God loves you. I love you, but God loves you more. And there's a whole lot that God has for you in this season. Do not miss what God has for you. Do not settle for less than what God has for you. Bring the blood back. Thank you for watching. God loves you. Bye-bye for now.